Good morning, students. In the previous video, we have discussed about work. So let us first recapitulate about work. So work is said to be done when force acts on an object and the object is displaced in the direction of force. We have discussed about the conditions of work done, that force should act on an object and object must be displaced. Only then work is said to be done in scientific term. Also, work done is the product of force applied and the displacement, and the formula for work done is F into S. The SI unit of work is joule, and 1 joule is equal to 1 nanometer. Also, we have discussed that work done is a scalar quantity, that it has only magnitude but no direction. So now let us talk about that work done by a force may be positive or negative. The work done by a force is positive if the force and the displacement are in the same direction. So work done is positive when the force and displacement are in the same direction. As we have discussed in our earlier video, the example of tug of war. The work done by the winning team is considered as positive work done. Also, the work done by a force is negative if the force and the displacement are in the opposite directions. Again, we take the example of tug of war. So the work done by the losing team is considered as negative work done. The work done by a force is zero if there is no displacement. Of course, it is not satisfying the condition of work done, and which is the object should be displaced when force is applied. So if there is no displacement, if there is no change in position, it means there is no work done. Also, the work done by a force is zero if the force is perpendicular to the displacement. So if the applied force is perpendicular to the displacement, then also the work done is considered as zero. So let us understand these by an example. When we lift an object, suppose this is an object, and when we lift it, the object moves in the direction of the force. For example, if we are applying the force in this direction, in the upward direction, the object is also moving in the upward direction. So here the direction of force and the displacement are same. So in this case, the work done is positive. But there is the force of gravity acting downward on the object. On the other hand, if we see that the gravity is acting in the downward direction, that is the force of gravity is acting in the downward direction, but the object is moving in the upward direction. Here the direction of force, particularly the force of gravity and the displacement of the object, is in the opposite direction. So in this case, we can say that work done is negative. So I hope by this example it is clear to you how the work done can be positive or negative. Now let us see one numerical. A porter lifts a luggage of 15 kg, so here mass is given to you, from the ground and puts it on his head 1.5 meter above the ground. So displacement is given to you, S is given to you. Calculate the work done by him on the luggage. So here firstly you have to write what is given to you from the statement. So here mass is given to you, which is equal to 15 kg, and displacement, that is S, is given to you, which is equal to 1.5 meter. And we know that acceleration due to gravity, this value is fixed, is 10 meter per second square. So work done, the formula for work done is F into S, and we know the formula for force, which is equal to mg, because here there is acceleration due to gravity. So instead of a, we have written g, and the value of g is 10 meter per second square. So we apply in this formula, instead of f we have to write mg, multiply by s, which is the displacement. So mass is given to you 15. The value of acceleration